What's going on, guys? Speedy Mormon here. Right now, low-key, I'm sitting in the middle of the Sneaker Shopping Museum. It's a monumental moment in the Sneaker Shopping series history because never before has this man answered questions, but finally, he is. Joe LaPuma, my dog.
Man,
how
thank
are you?
You so much.
There's a lot of history surrounding us, and we're going to get into a little bit of everything more specifically. But what made you want to do this?
You know, I always think it's good to engage with the audience, and social media is one thing, one way to engage, but I figured we could group a bunch of questions from the fans and I could answer them. That's why we're here, and thanks again for doing this.
Yeah, for sure. I feel like, at least when I scroll on Twitter, this is a long time coming. So off-rip, I'm going to read some of these questions off. It's an international show. This question is coming from Serbia.
Oh, wow.
Have you ever been to Serbia?
I haven't.
Neither have I.
Maybe this summer.
Yeah, maybe. All right, this is from Dimitri from Serbia. He says, who had the best stories out of all the people that have ever been on the show?
So the good thing about sneaker shopping that I like is that the questions are similar sometimes. You know, your first pair of sneakers or what sneakers made you fall in love with collecting sneakers. And sometimes we get stories that are directly related to sneakers or tangentially related to sneakers. One of my favorite stories was Chris Rock talking about when Michael Jordan hosted SNL.
He was the biggest star that had ever done the show. It was like normally, like we have famous people on every week. Yo, everybody wanted. So they got to the point they had to put a guard, a policeman outside Michael Jordan's dressing room for the cast.
But you know, Action Bronson had amazing stories, not related to sneakers. The Migos talked about getting into fights.
Somebody stepped on him on the bus, so we had to get out the bus. And I had to go in by my J's.
I feel like we try to get a good story every episode, and you ask questions that may seem similar, but you get different answers from different people.
Talk to me about how it feels when you're in the moment on the set and you know that a story that's never been told before is being told to you.
I mean, you know it too.
For sure, you know
how it feels. It's great. It's like you always want to leave an interview with, oh, that's really interesting. Mm-hmm. And you have to hide kind of your excitement when it's happening.
Has there ever been a moment, I'm sure, but what's been the moment where you left set and you knew in your mind, oh, we got one just now?
You know, Macklemore talked about his Jordans that he designed.
Well, the six was still in the design phase. Okay. I showed him the shoe. And you know, I have two pairs. I got the greens and the clays. And he was like, I don't like green. He was like, fuck green. It reminds me of some Christmas shit. Like no one's trying to wear some Christmas shoes.
Anytime you have a specific Michael Jordan story, it's going to make news. And I think that one was one of the first times that the show got TMZ.
Wow.
Yeah.
And that was
and it was like Michael Jordan doesn't like green sneakers, according to Macklemore. So
that was
a nice little news bit.
This is Andrew from Boston. He says, out of all of your guests on Sneaker Shopping, who had the most impressive or surprising knowledge about sneakers and about sneaker culture?
So a lot of times when I'm doing research, there's not a lot of sneaker information about celebrities. Mm-hmm. You go off kind of what they wear on their Instagram, or if they happen to talk about sneakers in an interview, then like you kind of luck out. Halsey, who I knew was into sneakers, but I wasn't sure how deep her knowledge was. She was super, super knowledgeable. And it was such a refreshing shoot when she was on. We shot her at Flight Club. You know, she grew up in the tri-state area. So she used to go to these stores and look at like the crazy sneakers and the cases and things like that. She was really, really knowledgeable. And Smoke Perp really had a lot of knowledge. And he prided himself on it. He was like, I used to go to high school. I knew all these sneakers. And then when we had Lil Pump on the show, he kind of validated Smoke Perp that this dude really knew his stuff, so that was cool.
Obviously, this is the sneaker show of the internet, so do you think that people, when they're coming on the show, knowing the magnitude of it, do a little extra sneaker research just in case?
I don't know. See, I don't want them to think that it's a quiz. It's not a quiz. Mm-hmm. And you know, we get feedback like, oh, they didn't know sneakers at all. Not everyone knows sneakers.
Sure.
As big as this is, a lot of people just look at shoes, and if they like how they look, they buy them. You know, we have Skip Bayless on, and he talked all about sports and covering Jordan in the 80s. I wouldn't consider him someone who you could quiz on sneakers, but it was like an enjoyable episode because he connected sneakers to the person and things like that. It's not pass or fail on this show.
Yeah, I feel like that's a point we need to drive home because I feel like, at least in my opinion, the sneakers are the entry point into a conversation.
Exactly.
I always see it. This person know nothing about sneakers.
Right.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Like not everybody needs to know Jordan 1 to 23
100%.
Every OG colorway. Like It's not about that.
100%.
Sneakers are just the entry point. That's it, guys. You got it?
Definitely.
Cool.
Thank you.
So obviously I said it in the intro, but we're kind of in a sneaker shopping museum right now. But the first thing that caught my eye when I walked in the room is maybe arguably the most iconic moment of the show, and it's DJ Khaled.
Yes.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Yep.
This is a gift that's
keeps on giving.
Yeah, yeah. It's the gift that keeps
sports
on
teams
giving.
Have used this. You and I know that we always send Khaled memes back and forth, or when he's on his Instagram and he comes up with another catchphrase. So we share a vested interest in Khaled's
DJ
humor.
Khaled. Yeah.
But when this happened,
there's 5 sneakers missing.
Really?
Yes. I hope it's none of my friends. Mm-hmm. We're gonna find that person.
Yeah.
When we do find them, once we get them back, I'm gonna give them right back to them.
Really?
Say, congratulations, you played yourself.
Everyone's laughing, and Khaled is not laughing. He's like, this is how I operate. And sure enough, it's I've seen t-shirts with that.
Made out of this?
Yeah, so it was a great moment, and I was happy I was there for it.
Word. Yeah. All right, you've had a lot of guests on the show at this point, obviously. Who would you bring back to do it all over again?
Tough question, but 50 Cent.
50?
50 Cent.
Because that was early on.
That was early on.
Right.
50 Cent was hysterical. He gave a very different view of the sneaker culture.
He was cheap, right?
He had a bag of like $40,000 with him, but he was very, very, very funny. Typical 50 Cent. I grew up such a big 50 Cent fan when I was starting my journalism career. So that's one where I would definitely love to run it back. And, you know, Power comes back August 25th. So
I'm ready.
Yeah, we need to hit up 50 and get him back on the show.
This is Kareem back in Europe from the Netherlands.
Okay.
He asks a question that's been asked a billion, trillion, gazillion, whatever the more is of that million time. The question is, why don't you do sneaker shopping with Travis Scott?
It's a good question. It's a question that is the bane of my existence every day. We haven't got Travis on the show yet, but that doesn't mean that we're not trying. Celebrities are busy, he's always touring, he's a huge megastar, and he has had awesome collaborations with Jordan and Nike, so I get why he is such a big requested guest, and it hasn't happened yet. Will it happen? I don't know.
Do you see light at the end of the tunnel? Do we have hope?
I'm optimistic. Do we have hope? It depends how optimistic you are. It depends if you're a hopeful person, but we're big fans of Travis at Complex. We would love to obviously have him on the show. He's kind of our white whale of sneaker shopping, and I'm not going to give up.
The ball's in Travis's court, so you are seemingly ready for him.
Fly out tonight if it happens.
So season 8 obviously just wrapped. When you look back on it, was there a high point for you?
I love the booking of season 8. You know that booking is very tough.
It's
we
tough.
Just talked about Travis. Booking is super tough, and our talent team does a really good job of booking. To have Guy Fieri and then Blueface, and then to have a Baker Mayfield and Lil Pump, all these opposite ends of the spectrum celebrities. And that's what I love about the show.
For sure. All right, so people always want to know what happens behind the cameras. Mm-hmm. What does it make the cut? So during season 8, do any stories come to mind about something that people may not know?
One thing about Blueface that was awesome is that he showed up like 90 minutes before his call time, which was, does that ever happen?
In rapper
never
time,
ever
that shit never happens.
Never happens.
He must have been excited to be on.
He was with his manager, WAC 100, in a new Porsche that WAC bought him for his birthday. He pulled up to the back of Flight Club and he was there super, super early. I guess he was just joyriding that new Porsche, which I would do too.
90 minutes early, do you appreciate that or are you annoyed? Because
no.
You needed the lead time to get ready mentally?
The director of the show, Jose, may be annoyed by that, but I'm ready to go at that point.
Any minute.
Let's go.
Talk about being on set for a second. When you're on set and you're with a guy like Future or Juice WRLD and they drop in 40 bands, the average American salary almost,
like
in a
nothing.
Single day.
Like nothing.
What are you thinking?
Up. The thing about those two guests is that they could have done more. Sometimes you shoot, they buy their sneakers and they're out. Those two could have probably went on for another 2 hours, seriously. The cool thing about Juice WRLD was amongst the shopping, he was buying so many articles of clothing and sunglasses and jackets and sneakers that I saw a Marshall speaker on the cash register and I thought he was just buying the speaker because I think Kith sells them.
Okay.
It turned out he wanted to play some unreleased music and he blasted music. It was probably 1 a.m. at that point on a Friday night, just blasting music, unreleased music, and it was a real treat. Those two shopping sprees were definitely a moment to witness.
I can't let you leave without at least giving us a walkthrough. Talk me through some of the stuff that we're seeing in this museum right here.
Yeah, so we have the tennis racket from Roger Federer's intro. We have Usain Bolt's track spikes that he signed for me. Canelo hooked me up with boxing gloves. Neymar, he's juggling a soccer ball in the intro. We have that. Obviously, the Macklemore 6s and the Khaled 3s. Khaled sent these friends and family Jordan 3s for the new album. The first episode of the new season, we did a pretty sick intro that mimicked the Tony Hawk video game. And
Pro Skater?
Pro Skater, and he's holding a skateboard.
And then there's some photos here.
Yeah, right? ASAP Ferg, Yachty. Little Yachty. We have two parts of his sneaker closet. His
collection. He impressed me, actually.
He's the man when it comes to sneakers. Yeah, actually posted these rare sneakers that I used to wear in high school that have never been.
Them.
Air Sunder Maxes with the zipper. We may have to go back in a year or so and
re-up.
Yeah, because that dude is always collecting. But yeah, so we accumulated a lot of cool things over the episodes that we have shot. And one day, you know, hopefully they go in like a man cave in the crib. So
where are they living right now? Are they not already at the crib?
They're not. They're in undisclosed locations, and they should probably be more secure than they are.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, you made it out of all of these questions unscathed.
Unscathed.
How are you feeling? Do you feel good?
Feel good.
For sure. Is there anything that I didn't ask quickly that maybe you just want to let people know?
I do want to let them know that even though we're off and we're taking a break, we do have some special content that's going to come in between the new season 9 and this break that we're taking. So you may see a few offshoot episodes of Sneaker Shopping, but season 9 comes back July 15th. Yeah, we'll see you in a few weeks.
For sure. Joe, this was fun.
Thank you, man.
Thank you
for coming in on your day off.
Of course, man. Right? We had to get the questions and the answers to the people.
Well, there's a pair of Travis Scott ones coming to you, maybe.
Oh, man, you don't gotta do that, bro. It's all good.
No, he bought some in Japan. They're not legit, so.
Oh, so fuck them. I don't want them shits anyway.